I'm Sharon Macklis, Director of Editorial Data and Analytics at IDG Communications. I'm here with episode 11 of Do More with R, schedule R scripts to run from the Mac command line. RStudio is a handy interface to work interactively, but sometimes, once you finish your script, you'd like it to run every week or every day without having to kick it off manually. For important mission-critical work, there are scheduling solutions like RStudio Connect. For smaller things where you can live with the occasional fail, you can set up a Mac to run scripts from the command line. Let me walk you through one way to do this. Here, I've got a test script that saves the system time in a variable called current time. The second line prints the current time. Third line creates a message variable with the character string, "This is a test I'm running at," and the current time variable. By the way, if you've never used the glue package before, it can be a nice alternative to using paste. Any code or variable name inside curly braces, like current underscore time, within a quoted character string gets evaluated, and the value is used in that string. Okay, fourth line uses the base R cat function, which displays or saves content of a variable. Here, I'm saving it to a file called test.txt. Let me run this with the source button. And you can see what my current time is in the environment tab here, and when the test.txt file was modified. Now I run that from the command line. There are a couple of ways to do this. I use the R script command. That should have been installed with R. You can find out exactly where that is by running which R script in your Mac terminal. And you can see where mine is. Let me change directory so my terminal is in my More with R directory. In this Linux-like terminal, the command to change directories is cd and not rsetwd. Now I can run my test.r script with rscript space test.r. And you can see that it ran. That's a Unix-Linux thing. Running the chmod change mode command on the file sets the file permissions. Typical way is with change mode 755 and the file name. 755 lets the file owner read, write, and execute the file, that's the 7, and everyone else can read and execute it, but not change it, those are the 5s. Let me do that. The last step is to set up what's called a cron job using something called cron tab. In theory, cron isn't the preferred way to do this on a Mac anymore. The new approved way is to use Apple's launch D. But I've been using cron for a long time, and I think it's easier than launch D. And cron still works. And there's a cool R package that works with cron and RStudio add-ins. If you're familiar with Unix cron jobs, you can schedule them in your Mac terminal the usual way. Otherwise, you may want to check out the cron R package. If you want its RStudio add-in to work too, you need a few other packages as well. Let me show you here. I like using the Pacman package for installing and loading packages. Here, I'm installing cron R from the BNOSAC GitHub repository. Then, with pload, I'm installing a few packages if they're not already on my system. MiniUI, Shiny, and Shiny Files. If they're already on my system, they just load. Mine are already on my system and installed, including the add-in. You can see it in RStudio under Add-ins. If you click Schedule R Scripts on Linux Unix under cron R, here's what comes up. I can choose my test file, pick the time I want, and then choose whether I want it running every hour, every minute, every day, and so on. Then I just need to click on the Create Job button at the bottom, and then done. You can see in the bottom left R Studio panel, details for the new cron job that was created on my system. In this case, it's saying it's not a cron schedule, but it will still launch. One really important point, the test.txt file that's created by this cron job will not be in my project directory. RStudio understands that you're in your project directory. Cron won't. On a Mac, that file will be in your home directory unless you specify another location. If your cron job includes saving a file, remember this. Otherwise, you can end up spending a lot of time wondering why your script isn't running, when it is running, but it's storing your data someplace you didn't expect. I know this firsthand. Oh, and one final point. Of course, if your Mac is off, the cron job won't run. But if it's asleep, the script won't run either. You can make sure your Mac wakes up a minute or two before your job is scheduled to run by going to System Preferences, Energy Saver, Schedule, and set the startup or wake time here. Okay, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the More with R video page at go.infoworld.com/morewithr. That's https://go.infoworld.com/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. Or you can add the Do More with R playlist to your YouTube library. So long, and hope to see you next episode.